Hey again, everybody. So in the last video, we did some geometry layout. We kind of blocked out our general office here. And in this video, we're going to add some windows and some doors to kind of open it up a little bit because it's kind of closed off here. So let's get started adding some doors and some windows. Because we did these modular pieces like this, adding doors and windows is going to be pretty easy. So we'll show you how to do that. We're going to add a door in this section over here, and then we'll add two windows on this side. So let's get started with the door first. Let's go ahead and click on this face here. Let's hold Alt and drag out a copy. Now, for the door, we know that our thickness needs to be 20, which is already set for us. But the width and height of the door, we don't exactly know what we want this to be. So we're going to just punch in some values to see what we get here. Let's set the Y to 150 and the Z to 250, for example. And that kind of looks like a door opening to me. Let's go ahead and press End on our keyboard to snap it down to the floor. And for the brush type, make sure that we set it to Subtractive. So that creates an opening once we drag it back into our wall like this. And there's an opening. That looks decent enough as an opening for a doorway. But we do have some starter content that we enabled. And inside of it, if we go down to the content browser here and click on Starter Content and Props, you can see we have a door frame. So we're going to actually place this door frame in here. And if we mouse over this, we can actually see it has an approximate size value. You see it's 25 by 114 by 212. We're going to actually use that value to kind of better guesstimate how big our door opening should be. So the X, Y, and Z, we are going to make some adjustments based on our door frame size. So for the X, we'll leave that to 20 because it's the thickness of our wall here. But the Y and the Z, we'll make some changes to that. For the Y, we'll set this to 110. And for the Z, we'll set that to 210. Now we can, actually, let's bring this down so it's back on the floor here. Looks like it kind of creates a lip there. We need to go up to the grid snapping. Let's set that to 5 temporarily and move it up. So there, it looks like it's flush with our floor now. So let's actually drag in our door frame and see if it fits now. There it is. So we're just going to drag and drop that in like so. It doesn't have to be perfect because we're going to position it as we see fit here. So let's fly around to the other side and pull it out a little bit. Let's see, is that too much? Yeah. Let's bump it over one more this way. So that looks good. There's a little bit of a lip on each side. And there we go. There's our door frame with our opening. And it's leading to our death currently as we walk outside of it because there's no floor out here. So let's actually really quickly select this floor piece, go ahead and hold Alt, create a copy by dragging it out and snapping it up against it like so. So there we go. Now we have a little bit of a landing area to walk out onto when we go outside of our door. So that looks good. Let's do the windows. Windows is pretty much going to be the same process here. So let's select this face and this face by holding Control. I'm going to hold Alt and drag out some copies. And for these values, you can see we have the SM window frame here. And again, there's our approximate size value of 25 by 94 by 144. So let's make some adjustments to our brush settings for these. First of all, let's make sure that they are subtractive. And for the X, let's go ahead and set that to 90. Let's set the Y to 20, the thickness of our walls, and the Z to 140. Okay, with those in place, let's grab the green arrow and push it back so that they are flush with our walls. And there you go. There are our openings for windows. So let's drag in the window frame now, same way we did the door. Just click, drag, and drop. I'm going to place it somewhere like this and then move it up like so. Then I'm going to press E to go into rotation mode and grab this blue arc here and just rotate it 90 degrees like so. W to go into move to make sure it's lined up. Let's move it this way just a little bit. That looks good. Something like that. And let's actually hold Alt and start to drag it out. While holding Alt, go ahead and hold Shift and move the camera with you. There you go. And place the other one, like so. So that was easy enough. We have two windows now and a door and some cool little shadowing effects over here. Don't worry about those for now. It's just because we haven't rebuilt our lighting like we did in the previous video. Let's add a skylight here before we finish up this video. So we're going to add a skylight up in this pane up here. So go ahead and select it and then hold Alt and drag the blue arrow down just a little bit. And for the brush type, let's go ahead and make that subtractive. And for the X, Y, and Z, you can set these to whatever size you want. We're going to set ours to 300 by 200, I guess. That looks like a good size of a skylight. Let's go ahead and drag this up into the ceiling so it is flush and create an opening. So there we go. We got a big opening there. Let's use our window frame up here. So we're going to drag our window frame in. And let's actually, you see how the window frame kind of pops into position there as you are holding it? So we're dragging it, and then we drag it to this lip, and it kind of pops in there. Go ahead and drag it so it kind of pops in there like this. This just makes it a little bit easier. So let's drag it up a little bit, and then drag it this way a little bit so it's in the center, kind of. Then we're going to press E to go into rotation mode and grab this green arc. And rotate it this way, 90 degrees, like so. And let's press R to go into scale mode. Now we're going to grab this box in the middle and just scale it up a little bit, like so. Then W and the blue arrow, drag it down. And it looks like it needs to come to the left a little bit. So grab the green arrow, push it over. Might need to scale it up a little bit more. Looks like I do. So I'm going to press R one more time and grab this box, scale it up. That should definitely fit. it's a little bit bigger than I wanted, so let's actually, how's it looking up here? That looks fine. Let's grab this red arrow on scale and just smush it a little bit, something like that. Then W, pull it up. And that looks pretty good. Good enough. For our purposes, as long as there's no holes and no seams. Okay, that's good enough. So that's that. We have our skylight, our door, and our two windows. We'll add some glass in it later, but for now I think this is good. We're gonna actually stop here. In the next video, we will start applying some materials so we can get rid of this checkerboard pattern and start to see our level come together a little bit better. And hope to see you guys in the next video.